In this video, we'll be looking at the use and functions of uplink ports on a network switch. This is a 4-port PoE switch, and you can see the uplink indicated on these two ports, indicating that this particular switch has two uplink ports. There are functional differences between the uplink ports and the regular switch ports. The uplink ports are designed with higher bandwidth and faster data transmission speeds compared to the regular switch ports. That is why it is most recommended that in linking two switches together, for instance, if I'm to link this switch to this switch, the best point to do that connection in the linkage between the two switches should be through the uplink ports. For example, you would have to link or connect a cable from one of the network switches into the uplink port of the other. And so this creates a better transmission between this switch and this switch. Or even in the case of connecting your switch to a router, it still goes the same way, whereby you take from the uplink port of one switch into the router. This gives you the opportunity to take advantage of the higher bandwidth offered by the uplink port of the switch, and also a faster data transmission speed for devices connected to the switch, so that you have a very good and well-performing network from the network switch into your device to which you are connecting your network switch. For network switches like this one, any of the regular switch ports perform dual functions, whereby they can receive device connections into any of the switch ports on the switch, and you can as well use any of these switch ports to uplink from this switch into another switch or into a router. For example, I can have cameras connected to this network switch this way. I can utilize any of the network switch ports, and I can use any of the network switch ports, maybe the last one here, can be used and connected into an NVR or connected into a router. If you do your connection this way, it works perfectly for switches that do not have uplink ports. And in a situation like this, all devices connected to the switch can be taken through the single connection you established to the device into which you are taking the device connections here. So let's take it that we were connecting maybe a number of cameras onto this switch. If we take the uplink through this point, all the cameras connected to the switch will be taken through this connection we have established to maybe an NVR or to a router into an NVR. So this will then become the uplink of this particular network switch. I hope this video explains the difference between regular switch ports and an uplink port on a network switch. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.